Okay, so next thing I want to explain is the following. So if I have, let's say, earlier, if you remember, if I had like 1 over 2 square root of 3, right? We said that to rationalize this denominator, all I needed to do was to repeat, right? Square root of 3, multiply it to the numerator and the denominator, and you know how to proceed from there, okay? The next case I want to tackle is, if instead of 1 over 2 times the square root of 3, I have 1 over 2 plus the square root of 3, okay? So in other words, instead of having one term in the denominator, I really have two terms, right? The terms being 2 and the other one is square root of 3. Now, if you try to do this same approach that we did earlier, which is just to multiply a numerator and denominator by square root of 3, try that. You're not going to really kick out the square root of 3 because that square root of 3 will get distributed to this. So this is an entirely different ball game, okay? We have two things here. This is like a binomial, okay? And we want to kick out the square root of 3, okay? Maybe I just tell you what to do, okay? I really don't know how to develop this very well, but all I want is to kick out that square root of 3. The thing to do here is we use that special product we met when we were doing polynomials, which is what? You use this product, a plus b times a minus b. When you multiply these two quantities, remember, see how they're almost alike except that one is the sum and the other is the difference? Remember that the answer to this became what? The difference of squares, right? A squared minus b squared. And again, the reason, I guess one way I can explain it is the way for this square root of 3 to disappear is to have a square root of 3 square, right? Okay, so this is what we are going to use, okay? This special product, all right? So our multiplier, as I proceed, I usually want you to copy the original problem so I know that's where it started, okay? Our multiplier will consist of, if you look at this, this denominator really looks like an a plus, right? That's a plus, okay? A plus b. So the partner, the factor that I need is the minus counterpart, okay? So if I have a 2 plus square root of 3 here, I would need to multiply that by 2 minus square root of 3. And what I do to the denominator, I have to do to the numerator. So that's that factor of 1 that's equivalent to 1 that you multiply, okay? So that's what's going to happen. And the good news is when you do this, let's see what happens when we do that. 1 times that is that, right? Okay. In the denominator, if we apply this formula, or if you don't remember this formula, you can just do FOIL slowly, distribute. You get 2 times 2 is 4, right? Okay? When you do this term times this, you'll get negative 2 square root of 3. This is going to be positive 2 square root of 3. Those two terms will cancel out each other. So you're really just left with the last and last, okay? Positive times negative is negative. Square root of 3 times square root of 3, you have two things, right? That's square root of 9 or 3 times 3, you can take out the 3. Did I explain that okay? So how did I get this? This was really square root of 9. 9 is 3 times 3. Remember, for a square root, we need two of the same factor. Take out 1, you get the 3. Okay? So you'll have 2 minus square root of 3 over 4 minus 3 is 1. So actually, you're done. There's no denominator. The denominator is 1. Okay? Let me see. So let's illustrate that. Let's do another example. Of course, it could be that, let's say you have some number here, let's say 4. Okay? And then maybe this is a square root as well. Let's say I have a square root of 5. Instead of a plus, maybe I can have a minus. Okay? Square root of 7, for instance. Okay? So same idea. Okay, which is I have two things here of the form A minus B. Okay, to rationalize this, let me copy the original problem again. Okay, I have to multiply numerator and denominator by this thing. Is really, some books call this the conjugate of this. Okay, if that's a minus, you have to multiply it by plus. Okay. If you make a mistake, some students repeat, they make it minus also. Carry out the multiplication and you will see that the radicals won't get kicked out, okay, if you accidentally just copy the same sign here. So it's really the opposite sign. If that's minus, that should be plus. If it's plus, it should be minus, okay? Hope you note that. Okay, so then, usually I recommend you keep the 4 there first before multiplying because sometimes some things cancel. So let's keep this. So we really just want to multiply this numerator by this numerator, okay? Now let's do the multiplication here. First with first, square root of 5 times square root of 5, that's 25 or 2 fives. So 1 5 comes out, right? Okay? When you multiply these two, and then these two, they're exactly the same except one is positive, the other is negative, right? So they cancel out. So the O and the I terms in FOIL will disappear, all right? Now when you look at this, negative times positive is negative, right? 7 times 7, 2 sevens inside the radical sign, square root, so you need 1 to come out, right? So you have 5 minus 7. And there you go. See why I didn't want to cancel to multiply the 4 inside? Because now what I have in the denominator is 5 minus 7, which is negative 2. Okay? 4 with negative 2 will cancel. This will become a 1 and that will become a 2. There's a negative 1 here. In the answer, it will figure as a negative in front, right? Well, probably if this were a problem in the book, your final answer will have the negative 2 distributed, okay? So anyway, just point out that sometimes you may find things that can simplify, so do not carry out the multiplication until the very end, except for the denominators where you want to see the radical sign disappearing. So for this one, the final answer is negative 2 square root of 5 minus 2 square root of 7, okay? So that's how you rationalize your denominator. If you have two terms in the denominator and their square root, okay? Make a note, I'm just explaining index 2 for right now. Okay. Of course, same concept can be applied to harder looking problems. Okay, so for my next example, let's make it look horrible. Okay, so if I have, let's say, 2 square root of 3, minus, let's say, 5 square root of 2, okay, over, let's say I have 3 square root of 5 plus 2 square root of, okay, 7, okay? It could look as ugly as this, but for as long as you know the principle being what? You look at the denominator, that's square root, right? Okay? So it's like you have an A plus B here, okay? So your first step is get that original problem, figure out your multiplier. Your multiplier will depend on the denominator, right? So your denominator is A plus B, so the multiplier has to be an A minus B, right? So it will be 3 square root of 5 minus 2 square root of 7. And whatever you do to the denominator, you do to the numerator. Okay? So that's 1, so we didn't change the problem. And then all you have to do really is patiently carry out the multiplication. Here I would recommend that you do perform it, okay? And it's 2 terms times 2 terms, so it's really just FOIL, okay? First, let us see, it just will look ugly, but it's the same concept, same principle, okay? So, let's do the denominators and see if the radicals will disappear. Grab this first term, multiply to that first term. 3 times 3 is 9, right? Then you have square root of 5 times square root of 5. You see the 2 5s, so you need 1 5 out, correct? Okay, square root of 5 times 5 is 5, okay? If you multiply these two, you'll get negative 6 square root of 35. You multiply these two, you get positive 6 square root of 35. They cancel out each other. So you don't need to worry about the middle terms, right? So now for these two, you have positive 2 times negative 2 is negative 4, right? Then you have 7 times 7. 2 sevens for square root, you need 1 out. Okay? There you go. So you have this, and it's radical free. There's no square root, so that means you did your job very well. Let's actually see what this is. This is going to be 45. 9 times 5 is 45. 4 times 7 is 28. 15 minus 8, 7. 17, right? Okay, so this is going to be 17 in the denominator. That's what you want to happen, okay? There are no radicals in the denominator.
Lay down all the tools and everything.
And then for this, you just have to multiply, again carefully using FOIL. 2 times 3 is 6, 3 times 5 is 15 inside, so you have 6 square root of 15. Outer with outer is going to be negative 4 square root of 21. Inner with inner is going to be negative 15 square root of 10. Last with last, negative times negative is positive 10 square root of 14. And the good news, I think, is if you look at these things, I don't think you can simplify them any further. So exactly the same numerator will get copied here, okay? And that's your final answer. Just looks horrible, okay? But same idea, just carefully carry out the multiplication.